Morning, everyone. We are away again. We're actually in Somerset at the moment. We spent the day yesterday in Exeter, met up with some friends who we haven't seen for absolutely ages, which was amazing. Had a coffee with them. And then we did a bit of shopping, which again, we've not done for so long. It was so nice actually being in the city, and it wasn't that busy actually. And we didn't buy much, just a couple of things for presents. So, but it was good. I really enjoyed it. Then we went out. Then we did a walk, and then we had a yummy roast dinner. So, and we've stayed last night in a Travelodge. We usually stay in Travelodges on our way back from the airport. And of course, we've had quite a few trips, as everybody has, in the last year cancelled, but we still had the Travelodges booked. You can't get your money back, but you can change, you know, where you want to stay. So we are going to head now to Glastonbury and stay for a couple of nights there, which I really cannot wait. I absolutely love Glastonbury. We're going to do a few things on the way. We're going to go to Street. There's a Clark's Outlet shopping village there, which we have been to before, but not for, I don't know, years. So be really interested to see how that is. We're going to get some breakfast. Then we're going to head to Wells and do a treasure trail around Wells before we head off to Glastonbury. Clark's Village is an outlet shopping centre in the town of Street, just outside Glastonbury. It's a really pleasant environment to shop in. There's lots of different outlet stores there. We didn't actually buy anything. I was looking for some shoes, and anybody who knows me will know that I really struggle with shoes. There's only a few brands that I like. But, you know, if shopping's your thing, I guess there's some good bargains to be had there. In my opinion, Glastonbury is one of the most interesting places to go shopping. There's lots of independent shops and different cafes, places to eat, lots of interesting people to chat to. I absolutely love it. There's some really good bookshops as well, and I mean, I could spend hours in some of them. Unfortunately, no shoes, but hey ho, that's just how it goes for me. I had a great time looking around the shops. In the afternoon, it was a bit cloudy, so we decided to walk up Glastonbury Tor, which has to be done when you're there.
Just in case.
View of the sunset over the KFC drive-through. Morning, everyone. We are on our second day in Glastonbury today. We didn't actually make it to Wells yesterday because we were still looking for shoes in Glastonbury, and then we walked up the tour, which was fantastic. Absolutely love it up there. The views are amazing. We had a great night as well, actually. We're staying in the Travelodge, as I said, just outside Glastonbury, and we thought it was going to be a bit of a walk into the town, but actually it's fine. It was, I don't know, like 15 minutes flat. Quite a pleasant walk. Nice view of the tour as you're walking along, and it takes you right into the bottom bit of the town by the Abbey, which was fantastic. So we are going to go to Wells this morning, which obviously I said we were going to do yesterday. We've got a treasure trail to do, so we're going to head off to Wells, hopefully get some breakfast again. It's so nice being able to eat out and be in pubs and cafes, and it's amazing. So we're going to do that this morning, and then we're going to go and visit Glastonbury Abbey this afternoon, which neither of us have ever been to before, so I'm really looking forward to that. And then I guess we'll go out again this evening, try and find some dinner. Wells is England's smallest city. It's a really beautiful, friendly place, and we loved exploring in the sunshine. We were quite surprised to see everywhere we went there was bunting, every shop, every house, the school, literally bunting everywhere. And we learnt that it was made by the residents for their community bunting project. Between them, they made 1.5 kilometres of bunting. Wells has an impressive Gothic-style cathedral and the Grand Bishop's Palace, which is surrounded by this beautiful moat. We walked all the way round it and were really impressed. This is Vicar's Close, situated right near the cathedral. It's the oldest purely residential street in England, and it's so pretty, well worth a visit. Afternoon, we visited Glastonbury Abbey. It was such a beautiful sunny day, and it was so nice to just walk barefoot on the grass and take in the beautiful surroundings. We really enjoyed our time away in Somerset. Highly recommend the Travelodge for a budget break. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next video.